welcome back to another video. It is now the start of spring, and to welcome in the new season, I was thinking about making some fun and crafty clay things, mostly just because I want to work with my hands again. If you're kind of a long viewer of mine, you can kind of see that I like to go from working on digitally on my iPad or Photoshop to taking breaks in between of just like crafting and fun DIY things from time to time. It's like a weird cycle of trying to do a little bit of each medium all at once, but honestly, I think it works for me. I'm mainly a digital artist and I work in Photoshop and Procreate, and I am a full-time background painter in the animation industry. But from time to time, I really like to work with clay. It's been a hobby of mine ever since I was little. But nowadays, I'm really just getting into the spring vibes and welcoming in all the fun and floral themes. So I wanted to celebrate that and make some clay earrings and also the clay like jewelry trays, mostly just plates and places to hold your jewelry that could be very cute and can match the earrings. And actually, the main source of inspiration that made me want to make these types of cute fun clay things is the sponsor of this video, which is Ana Luisa. So I actually got to collaborate with them back in November last year, and they sent over some really nice pieces of jewelry then. This floral bracelet was one of the main inspirations because I feel like this very simple daisy pattern is very trendy these days. It's a very fun and uplifting little shape, which I love greatly. This time around, they have a campaign for Mother's Day, and they were very kind enough to send me a discount code for you guys. So if you want to get 10% off all the jewelry, there is a coupon code and link in my description below. And it's a really funny code this time around. It's ShoeVicky10. Please enjoy that. So a little bit about Ana Luisa. They are a sustainable jewelry company that makes carbon neutral jewelry at some pretty fair prices. They have pieces that start from $39 and upwards, so that there's a range for everybody. And I have some of my favorite ones here. This time around, they sent me some very fun earrings and also one necklace. So to complement this floral daisy bracelet, I actually got some more floral things because who doesn't love daisies? These earrings here are definitely one of my favorites. It actually has a very cute name as well. These guys are called Beauty Within, but it's also known as Flower Huggy Hoops, which I think is just incredibly cute and cuddly. And they really make for some cute dangling earrings. I also got some pearl earrings to just complement everything that I'm wearing these days. And that is called Frida, or also known as the Pearl Huggy Hoops. They're very sweet and delicate, and what I love about Ana Luisa's jewelry the most is that it's very dainty and subtle. As you can notice, I have 4 piercings total, I think. I have 5 piercings total, and a lot of the times I really like to keep it simple because it's really great for just everyday wear. And the last piece I got is actually this very sweet necklace, which is called Sam. This is the interlocking circles necklace, and I really love how it goes with some very simple pieces, or it could go over some shirts and overlap and just be fun with fashion. And yeah, it's been really awesome working with Ana Luisa, and now it's time to get into making and crafting and DIYing some pretty floral things. So starting off, I'm just kind of collecting all the scrap pieces of clay that I've been collecting for quite some time, and my main source of clay has just been this one giant block of Sculpey clay that I bought probably 3 to 4 years ago, and I'm still using it. And because it's a DIY project, I don't have a lot of clay tools on hand, so I just use paintbrushes instead. Thank you.
Now moving on to making the clay earrings, I found these three blocks of colored clay, and for some reason they were all different brands of clay. I found that it's harder to use colored clay because I have a hard time keeping the clay clean. There's always a lot of dust and speckles of dirt that get stuck in between the color, so I end up having to paint it regardless of what I do. But what I do like about the clay is that there's a different consistency to it. Unlike the large block of Sculpey, these three clays tended to be a lot firmer and easier to work with because sometimes the regular Sculpey would just melt in my hands due to the heat and it would just get really messy. Going on to one of the final steps, and probably the funnest step, is painting everything. I wanted to have a little bit more fun color blocking everything so that every edge was a little different, and also I really love grid and checkered patterns, so that is what I went with today. So here are all the pieces so far. Everything's pretty nice and I'm just ready to glaze. It was a little hard applying some of the paint, mostly just because it's a little tedious, especially with these guys because they're so small. Look at how tiny these bees are. Incredible. But I would say without a doubt this one's my favorite, the paintbrush holder. Very cute. And then the last thing I have to deal with is my resin. This guy decided to spill everywhere, and now I'm trying to get the remains out.
It is now many days later because I totally underestimated how long it would take to make everything from start to finish, but it's all done! I've got these guys here, which are the jewelry holders, and I really like how this one turned out. This one I still think is very cute, but it's not as interesting or unique. And I like this one because there's a bunny. I needed something in the center to hold rings and something to just anchor everything. So I was thinking, what would be good in the middle of a flower shape? It would just be like a bulb. Why not make it a little more interesting and put a bunny on it? And it turned out rather cool. And I love how the clay pieces look with the resin on top. Just makes it look very chic. There's definitely a quality to polymer clay that is very different from ceramics, so the resin kind of just mimics the ceramic look, and it turned out not bad. And then here are all the finished earrings. I admittedly had a lot of frustration with these guys because one, my resin decided to spill and I had no idea about it until today, and I had so very little left to work with, and it was very messy process. And two, because I was rushing the resin process, trying to salvage whatever resin I had left, I actually covered over some of the holes that I needed to put the findings and the hoops in. And so now I just can't use some of my earrings. I just have a handful of these pieces, which is about half of the ones that I made, that aren't viable for earrings because they either have very small holes where I can't fit anything into, or they have the resin covering the holes. So I think I'm going to repurpose these into different things. I think in the coming future I'm going to be bringing these guys to the store because these are very me. So in the future, when I make more of these guys for the store, I'm probably just going to attach these guys on and make it a little more interesting. And just so these guys aren't wasted and all my valuable hard work and time doesn't go down the drain for this tiny little bee. It's all good though, everything still turned out pretty nice. There's definitely a lot of things that I still struggle with and that I'm still learning about clay, polymer clay specifically. But because these are handmade items, there's a lot of imperfections into them, but I guess that's just what makes them a little more charming. And here's the other thing that I ended up making, which is the paintbrush holder. I love this guy. He is my favorite out of everything I made this week. And there's a light side to it and then a darker side. So yeah, I hope you had a little bit of fun joining me on this little craft with me session. I had a lot of fun just kind of trying to figure out what the heck I was trying to make. And definitely trying out a lot more colors that are not fall based. And just a little reminder to check the description down below for 10% off Ana Luisa, and everything's great. I'm excited to be bringing these guys to the shop soon and a little spring update, so please look forward to that. I guess that's it for me now, and the next time you'll see me, I think a lot of things might change. Who knows? We'll see. It may or may not have to do with a lot of pom-poms. I hope you take care, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye!